Hey there, what's going on? How about that? We're making a potassium smoothie. So yeah, we have some potassium ingredients here. Not so much this one, but more so coconut water, avocado, pistachios, and walnuts. Yeah, we'll put some cinnamon in here too. I don't think this has any potassium, but it's always good to have a little cinnamon in your smoothies if you can. Helps you control your blood sugar a little bit. And then, I don't know if you ever heard of something called the 100th monkey phenomenon. This was based on some studies in Japan back in the 40s or 50s, where they had these monkeys on an island, and they would put sweet potatoes and I think wheat on the shores of these islands, and they would measure like a critical mass of how these monkeys were washing the sweet potatoes. And if one island got up to a certain number of monkeys that figured this out, then it would like automatically jump to another island where they started washing the sweet potatoes similarly. The reason I bring that up is I have some other potassium products over here. I've got this electrolyte powder, which has 1,000 milligrams of potassium. And I also have this broccoli, the organic broccoli. This has good potassium in there as well. But I'm not going to put it in the smoothie, but I figure by having it in the general area of my smoothie that it might actually give it more potassium energy, sort of like the 100th monkey phenomenon. What do you think about that theory? Put some comments down below if you think having my electrolyte powder sitting here or my broccoli sitting here, is that going to give my smoothie any more potassium reading at all? Even if it's 1/1,000,000th of a milligram of potassium. Vote yes or no down in the comments below if you think I'm going to get extra 100th monkey potassium by having these products sitting here, but not in the product itself. Kind of a theoretical, philosophical, what did they call that? Esoteric question, maybe. Okay, we're going to start off with the coconut water. This has good potassium in here. Real potassium, not 100th monkey potassium. Potassium 451 milligrams per cup. So this will probably be about 900, because I'm going to put probably. Yeah, I don't think I'm going to put two full cups. Let me see. Yeah, I'll put two cups exactly. There. So it's 900 milligrams of potassium. And then this avocado probably has about the same amount. Oh, this video, by the way, was inspired by a question by one of our viewers. Thank you, Stephanie, for the potassium question. She was wondering what other foods contain potassium. So we decided to make a potassium-rich smoothie to focus on potassium here. Alrighty, so what do we have so far? We have coconut water. We're going to put a handful of walnuts. I don't think there's a lot of potassium in walnuts. I'm just going to put a few in there. There's more potassium in the pistachios. I think a cup of pistachios has about 600 milligrams. So I'm going to put about a quarter cup of these in there, and So that gives us maybe, if we're lucky, a couple hundred milligrams of potassium. Save a couple for a treat later. Okay, let's go ahead and put our avocado in there. We could name that tune going on in the background over here. If the song is not listed in the show notes, then you can earn Channel 19 Headless Chef bonus points by putting the artist or the song in the comments below. If you put both, that's the best. So yeah, we're adding our avocado here. Into our potassium smoothie. Yeah, the 100th monkey philosophy has more to do with like behavior or an idea, something like that. It doesn't really have with like things, doesn't really have to do with like things sitting around like this. But it's sort of a philosophical question. If you want to know what I believe, there might be a placebo effect where just by having more potassium here, just by me asking the question, I might perceive that there's more potassium in here in terms of the way it makes me feel. But it will be a placebo effect versus actually having more potassium. That's my theory. Okay, awesome. What we're gonna do is we're gonna put some coconut mana in here for some flavor. Maybe a tablespoon or so. This stuff tastes pretty good. This is 100 calories per tablespoon. So I'm gonna put this much in there for flavor. I'm gonna taste a little wedge of it. Mmm, boy, that stuff is really good. Do yourself a favor, pick up some coconut mana. I got this one off of Amazon. It's pretty reasonably priced too, considering they ship it to your door if you have Prime. I think two of these jars is like $16, and it's almost a pound. So that'd be 2 pounds. It's gluten-free, vegan, 1 gram of sugar per serving. Total 9 grams of fat. The good fat. Two grams of fiber. 1 gram of protein per tablespoon. Okay, hey, we're kind of getting to the blending point here. So far we have coconut water, avocado, walnuts, pistachios, coconut mana. If you wanted to, you could put some frozen blueberries or something in there. If you wanted to get a little fruit. I'm gonna put some cinnamon in there. Let's go ahead and see what it's like without the frozen fruit. This coconut water was cold from the refrigerator, so that'll give it a nice cold feeling right off the bat. All right, we're gonna go to our next song here and name that tune. Okay, checking for the lid here. There's some more light for you. Checking for the lid here for the blender. I guess I'm just gonna do the blend it on low trick and kind of hope it doesn't squirt up. You ready? Might want to plug your ears or turn down your volume while we blend up the smoothie here. The potassium smoothie. If you wanted to, you'd call it the potassium bomb. You could call it the bomb. You could call it potassium smoothie, smoothie potassium, smoothie a la potassium. Put in the comments down below what you think a good name is for the smoothie. And we might even rename it if you have a good suggestion that we like. See more action, you can check out the other volcano recipe, volcano smoothie. Had some pretty good volcano action on that one. All right, let's see what we have here, folks. This is a smoothie. It might not be done yet. We're gonna give it a taste here and see if it's done. Mmm. Oh yeah, that's certainly worthy of drinking. Mmm. It's really good. It has sort of that nutty feel. Kind of sweet, salty and sweet. Salty a little bit from the nuts, but sweet from the coconut water. Hearty, plenty of calories. Mmm. Yeah, if you're trying to watch your blood sugar or your carbohydrates, you gotta kind of watch out for this coconut water. So yeah, in one cup of this, there's 10 grams of sugar and 11 grams of carbohydrates. So that's not too bad. We have 22 grams of carbohydrates and 20 grams of sugar. But you know, it's more like natural sugar versus added processed sugar. Because the ingredients are organic coconut water. Oh, it also has organic sugar. So maybe it is added sugar. Yeah, so maybe try to limit your coconut water to one cup if you're concerned too much about your sugars and carbs. That's 10 grams of sugar already in one cup. Depends if you want to get more potassium. If you wanted to, you could add a scoop of this and get 1,000 milligrams of potassium. The avocado is probably close to 1,000 as well, maybe another 900. So we had 900 from the coconut water, 900 from the avocado is 1,800. And then some from the pistachios, it's probably about 2,000 milligrams. I'm not sure how much walnuts have, not very much. And if you're trying to get 4,700 milligrams of potassium every day, a smoothie like this would help to get 2000 right off the bat. From there, you could have like a spinach salmon salad. That would give you another 1,000. Yeah. So you can see how it's not easy to get 4,700 milligrams of potassium. That's why we like the new salt. You can add this to water. You can add it to your salads. This gives you a lot of potassium. Five thirty in 1/6 of a teaspoon. So if you have a teaspoon of this, that gives you about 3,100 milligrams of potassium. One teaspoon of this and you're well on your way to your day's supply of potassium. I might have to say the smoothie's good enough as is. So that's good, because if I would have added blueberries or some other fruit in there, I would have added more sugar. So I gotta kind of keep an eye on that. Let's just go ahead and get this in there. Toast to you. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, what we could do too is add some collagen protein if you want. My favorite protein for the smoothies is this chocolate collagen, which I've used before on my smoothies. But I'll show you a little trick here you can do. Extra little trick here for you. So here's the trick. I'm just going to take a little bit of collagen protein and I'm going to put it right in my mug. Instead of mixing it in the smoothie, I put it straight in the mug. Because notice how this blender has a whole bunch of stuff stuck on the sides. This protein powder is like not cheap. By putting it straight into your mug and stirring it up, you don't have to worry about getting caught on the blender on the way out. Stir it in real quick and it's ready already. It absorbs nicely. That one idea alone will probably save you $500,000 over the course of your life. Okay, maybe not that much. Mmm. Oh, and the flavor. Man. That's almost a better way to do it, because when you stir it in, it kind of has little pockets of collagen protein that don't get fully blended into the liquid. So they're like little candy balls like BB size or smaller that kind of explode in your mouth. Mmm. Really outstanding. It's sort of an outstanding chocolate exploding smoothie right in your mouth is what it is. And it's high potassium too. I probably just had 2,000 milligrams of potassium. I doubt if the collagen protein has any potassium, but let's see. Oh my God, it does. 160 milligrams in two scoops. So I had only about 3/4 of 1 scoop. So that was probably only about 60 milligrams, but at least it's something. Here, you see it right here. It's the bottom ingredient there, potassium. Yeah, so be sure to check out our other potassium videos. If you see the word potassium in the video name, it means it's a high potassium recipe. Or if you just happen to see any of these ingredients in any of the other recipes, avocados, coconut water, or pistachios, you'll know you're getting some extra potassium in that recipe as well. Here's a pop quiz question for you. The pink Himalayan sea salt. Does it have any potassium? Hint. It has potassium on the label. But leave a comment down below based upon your research on Himalayan pink sea salt and how much potassium it has or does not have. 100% raw, natural, and unrefined product here. Himalayan pink sea salt. Yeah, I guess this stuff comes straight from the Himalayan mountains. That's where Mount Everest is. The rich pink color comes from the 84 natural minerals embedded in the rock salt. This pure product has no additives or preservatives and is considered a healthier alternative to table salt. The versatile salt enhances the flavors of any dish. Enjoy! Yeah, I think this is a Costco product if you want to get it in bulk. This comes in a 2-pack. Yeah. Leave any comments down below you'd like, whether it's regarding the 100th Monkey, Himalayan pink sea salt, potassium, your favorite recipes, anything at all. This concludes our video today on our potassium smoothie. Thanks for tuning in to The Headless Chef on Channel 19. Until the next video.